Alright, it's about time I thought about doing something other than Mario ROM hacks, which is, well, actually the second best thing, is a Mario editor and game player type thing, so, not really all that different. Anyway, I'm gonna be playing The Invasion 2. I wish I had names, because I would like to give credits. So you can see here, there's actually 5 characters to use, and last time I only used Mario. However, for this video, I think I'm gonna go with Toad, seeing as he was actually my favorite for Super Mario Bros. 2. So without further ado, let's start. Now the dialogue might not make any sense, seeing as I'm Toad, and you can actually put dialogue in this thing. Anyway, so here's Princess Daisy, and she says,
"They wouldn't let me in, but I had to talk to you. Don't look at me like that. Something bad is happening. Bowser has joined forces with villains from other realities and is invading the Mushroom Kingdom. Please go foil Bowser's plans like you always do."
Now, I have a pretty strong feeling that that used to be Princess Peach, but seeing as she's a playable character now, it had to be swapped around. Anyway, this Toad says, "Oh no, where did the princess go?" In my house. Go take a look.
"A princess should not be making house calls to a plumber."
Hey, I'm not a plumber, I'm one of you guys. Yeah, I'd normally be Mario or Luigi for this, but, no. Anyway, so the super easy road, which as its name describes is, well, super easy. Jeez. This game is lagging for some reason, and I don't know why. Anyway, did you know that you can change your character at the world map screen? All you have to do is pause the game and press left or right. Yeah, that's actually something pretty handy because, well, some characters actually have a really hard time making it through some levels. Like ones that require spin jumping or the like, or flying. Which Toad here, despite being able to get a flight-style power, cannot actually fly with it. And as you can tell, his fireballs are a bit wonkier from Mario, seeing as they bounce really, really low. Now, holding up will actually make me throw them at a higher arc, but that doesn't do anything for the bounce. But what Toad here can do is, if you hold the alternative running button, he can actually hold his fireball over his head, which he can then proceed to throw like an ordinary item. Which means you can throw it straight up, straight down, if you ever felt like it, or in a strange pattern of two. Maybe it's because I'm spinning, I don't know. Anyway. You can have a lot of fun with that if you screw around with it. Anyway, moving on. More easy level. Which, not that much of a shock. Now, the thing with this fan game is that sometimes it will lag. And when it does lag, it spikes back into where it was supposed to be. Rather than, slowly catching speed, it will, well, you might see eventually, actually. Anyway, so we'll go to the Grassy Grass Grasslands. Because, as you may have noticed, seems to be a funny thing about Mario names is that it's always something land, isn't it? You can't just use grassland on its own, you gotta go overkill. Alright, so, as you can see, this is pretty much Super Mario Bros. 3 physics. More or less into a Super Mario World style as far as all the power-ups work. Now, seeing as I'm Toad, I'm actually more akin to a Super Mario Bros. 3 health system, where I have 3 hits when I'm fully powered up. But the thing is that I could have 3 hits anyway if I had enough mushrooms and no power-up. So I'm guessing that's why there's a 3-heart system for Toad and Peach, who plays similarly to her Mario Bros. 2 style, for those who don't know. Ouch. Yeah, now I have 2 hearts left, and, oh, lag. This is going to spike at some point, I can just feel it. Now, the thing about Koopas is that they don't seem to ever regenerate. As in, they don't ever seem to come back to life after being stuck in their shell for too long. But anyway. Yeah, you can quickly rack up extra lives here, I suppose. My goodness, I hate this lag, and it has something to do with Bandicam in this game, I think. I hope it'll fix up soon. I've got freaking Game Booster on. It's not doing that much to help. Okay, so in here we go. Yeah, the creator of this little game has graciously allowed Toad to do Mario and Luigi's patented spin jump. Which is nice, considering he doesn't have anything to deal with tricky jumps like spiked foes or foes that are on fire or something like that. Anyway, so down further I go. Further demonstrating my skills of moving around. Okay, drop you there. While you blow yourself up. Ooh, another fire flower, which I cannot store because I'm not Mario or Luigi. Okay, so you might notice that there's a bunch of coins going down there. That's all well and good. That's the normal exit. Now for this little exit. Now, I don't know why Toad can duck underwater. Maybe it's just a silly little quirk. Oh yeah, and unlike Super Mario World, you can actually swim around normally while carrying an item. And yes, I did have to duck there in order to use the key on it. Because the key needs to be the object that touches the hole, just like in Mario World. This little place is called Get Off My Lawn, and you'll see why. You boys better get off my lawn! Now, here's the quirk with this little spot. This is actually one of those Toad House type things, like in Mario 3. Now I go in here, my squishy Goomba. I hijack a Karibo shoe and an ice flower. Now he says something different. Can't believe you broke into my house. You better not have hurt Hugo. Oh, I squished his friend. I'm so cruel. I also stole his stuff, but who cares? Yes, you might notice that the ice flower in this version actually bounces twice. Also, enemies do not come back to normal after having been iced. And then you can throw them like so. Makes this a very cheap weapon, especially when, you know, a lot of the times your fireballs won't work on something. But anyway. Okay, so down again. Ouch. Right. Ice doesn't work on those guys. Alright, now to... Crap, I'll be back. Okay, sorry it took me so long, but I'm back. And lag. I really hate lag. Lag can go to heck. Anyway, so that's a normal exit. I wish I would have talked to that Toad there so that you'd know what he said, but, you know. Forget all that. The floating brick niche. In case you're wondering how I got this again, well, I actually just quit the game, which lets you keep all of your stuff, including power-ups, lives, before the level you went into. Because this game has a sort of autosave feature where you save every time you beat a level or exit it. So, yeah, here's the cool thing about Toad, is that he actually hits 5 coins out of a block at once. Apparently because he hits it so hard. Okay, the ouch. Stupid Goomba generator. I'm also supposing that Toad can throw his ice balls like that too, but, you know, I keep forgetting stuff like that. Yeah, one of Toad's other quirks is that he actually holds things above his head, like Donkey Kong holds barrels over his head. And in order to get rid of all the purple blocks, I'm going to be here all night. No, you're not. I'm going to help you. And it's not really all that hard. Jeez. Okay, so really all you gotta do is, dump... There's a whole bunch of, fuzzy beetle shells generating out of this pipe, and all you really have to do is just throw them down. Just throw them down all of these holes. Just throw them down all of these holes. Good Lord, Toad, you suck. No wonder nobody picks you. Ugh. That's the other thing about his quirk, is that his shells actually bounce a little bit before hitting their destination. So it can be a little hard when you're trying to get them down a hole or something like that. But I digress. So after waiting for all those shells to, do their stuff... As you can see here, mushrooms don't screw up with your power-ups, like they might have done in Mario World. That's actually something to note, is that if you're using Mario and Luigi who have reserve items and have a health system like Super Mario World, where if you get hit you lose all of your power-ups, including the mushroom that was underneath your fire flower or whatever, but then you have your reserve item, which also helps. So anyway, I think I destroyed them all. Got rid of all the purple blocks. As a reward, I'll open this door for you. Thank you, sir. Now I can go get the star. Now, the thing about stars is that they can be used to open doors, as you might have seen if you watched my Let's Play of the other Super Mario Bros. X game that I did. So, like, for example, you can have set rewards here, like this one requires 5 stars, this one takes 6. All these are just warps that exit out to another place on the map. Welcome to the Star Palace. There are special treasures waiting for you if you can collect enough stars. Oh, I'm sure there is. You need 7 stars. There's a grand total of 7 here, actually. 3. Pretty much one for each of these portals here. As you can see, if I try to exit through another one, it doesn't take me anywhere that I can go. So, anyway... going back to the first world, because I'm not quite done there yet. And lag. The floating brick niche once more. You know, I should probably be doing like my other... ouch. Like my other vids where I just cut back to where the last point was, but I kinda don't feel like it this time. I don't know why. It's just a waste of time watching me go through the same paths over again, isn't it? But hey, that's a spice of life. I need to be a little more spontaneous, I guess. Because spontaneity keeps things interesting, and... well, keeping things interesting makes everything less boring for everyone else. Isn't that right? Right. Okay, so more coins, more note blocks. And more, shell tossing. More shell tossing because Toad sucks. Okay, you go down there, Buzzy Beetle Shell. That's right. You can do it, you can do it, you can do it! Come on, come on. Finish up. Thank you. And checkpoint for no apparent reason, because actually the goal is not that far away from here. Well, maybe it's a little further than I remembered. I actually just played through this level a few minutes ago just so that I could get used to how this game controls, because it's more like Super Mario Bros. 3 instead of Super Mario World. And getting used to one kind of physic is really hard to get back to another one. Yeah, see? That checkpoint was all of about 5 feet from the goal, so it really didn't make any difference. Anyway, I suppose I should stop the video here, so see you next time.